Dear students of Zoology Department, Nirmala College, as in today's scenario, we are unable to take the regular classes. We are here with the online classes illustrated with presentation. Today, I'll be talking about the scales of fishes. Under this topic, you have to start your notes with introduction, types of scales, as well as the uses of scales. Of course, modifications of the scales will also be there. The body of vertebrates bear exoskeleton that make the protective outer covering. They have originated either from epidermis or dermis. Dermal scales are mesenchymal in origin and especially developed in fishes. They are small, thin, cornified, calcareous or bony plates which fit closely together or overlap. In this slide, I'm talking about the development of scales. I have taken the example of development of plecoid scales. Let us first talk about the skin of the fish. You can see two layers in it. One is dermis, another is epidermis. Dermis lies underneath epidermis and is made up of two layers. The upper loose connective tissue and the lower, which is near to our muscular layer, is compact connective tissue. Above this lies the basement membrane, sitting upon which is stratum germinativum layer of epidermis, which constantly is giving out the epidermal cells that become cornified, and some of them become the mucous cells too. The first sign of developing scales in the skin of the fish is an aggregation of mesodermal cells of dermis lying just beneath epidermis. They form dermal papilla. As the epidermis is pushed up, the outermost cells of dermal papilla become odontoblasts and deposit dentine between themselves and epidermis. Meanwhile, the overlying epidermal cells of stratum germinativum, now called amyloblasts, they start forming enamel, which deposits vitrodentine over dentine. Cement or basal plate is formed from surrounding cells of dermis. On a growing scale, the dermal papilla forms nutritive pulp overlying the pulp cavity. In a fully formed scale, epidermis wears off around the spine, which projects above the skin, while the basal plate remains embedded deep in the dermis. Five types of dermal scales have been identified in fishes. They are cosmoid, plecoid, ganoid, cycloid, and ctenoid scales. The first scale that I am going to talk about is cosmoid scale. These scales do not occur in the living fishes. These were the characteristics of certain ostracoderms, placoderms, and extinct sarcopterygians. Except one sarcopterygian, Latimeria chalumani, the low-finned fish, which is present with us, bears cosmoid scales. In cosmoidal scale, there are four distinct layers: an innermost thin enamel-like ganoid layer, thick and dentine-like cosmoid layer. Then the third layer is of spongy bone, and the innermost layer is of compact bone. You can see them in this diagram, as well as Latimeria fish with its scales are illustrated here. Second type of scale is plecoid scale, which develops from epidermis as well as dermis, and they are the characteristics of elasmobranch fishes like scoliodon. Each plecoid scale consists of a backwardly directed spine, which is trident, arising from a rounded or rhomboid basal plate. In this slide, you can see the structure of plecoid scale, which is trident and has a basal plate with a bulk cavity in which the living cells are present, and blood vessels and nerve cells are also present in the pulse cavity. Third type of scales are ganoid scales that are diamond shaped and are like plates closely fitted side by side, like the tiles or like the bony armor to the fishes. These ganoid scales are composed of three layers: outer enamel-like ganoid, middle dentine-like cosmoid, and inner bony isopodine. The fishes like Polypterus, Acipenster are ganoid fishes. Cycloid scales. They are thin, flexible, translucent plates. They are sometimes circular in shape, thicker in the center, and are marked by several concentric lines of growth. With the help of this, we can determine the age of fishes. Cycloid scales are composed of a thin upper layer of bone and a lower layer of fibrous connective tissue. They overlap each other. Each scale is embedded in a small pocket of dermis. Cycloid scales are found in lungfishes as well as in surviving deipnoids, some holosteans, and lower telosteans such as carp, cod, etc. Ganoid scales are the characteristics of modern higher teleosteans. They are more firmly attached and their exposed free hind parts, which are not overlapped, bear numerous small comb-like teeth or spines. You can see the growth line in the ganoid scale. Perch, sunfish are the teleost fishes carrying these types of scales. Scales may get modified and may do different work for the fish body. Sometimes the plecoid scales, like in sharks, get modified into teeth. They may become a sting of a stingray. As well as in sawfish, they become the lateral teeth on its elongated rostrum. Other scales, rather than plecoids, do also get modified and may become a spine protecting the complete body, as in case of porcupine fish, or may become bony boxes as in trunk fishes. They may also make the protective bony ring around the body, like in seahorses and pipe fishes. You can see here eel fish, which has very small scales that are embedded deep into its skin. Chimeras, tetradon, and string whales, talking about their modified scales. Trunk fish, porcupine fish, and seahorse, talking about modified scales of their body. Scales on the body of the fishes are very useful for them. They work as protective covering. For us also they are useful because they help us to determine the age of the fish. Every scale bears growth line, which talks about the age of the fish. Besides that, they help to identify the fishes. Depending upon the type of the scale or their modification or their distribution on the body, we can identify as well as classify them. This way, the scales are helpful for taxonomy too. Thank you.